passionate fans of this hobby can rightly be called creators. Every day they devote several hours to painstaking, delicate and very complex work, and they do that for several years. They live with that. Fans of ship modeling can spend over a week on trying just one micro node on the sail of the future copy of a famous ship. In Generation UA, we will learn what makes thousands of people around the world build models of ships. Ship modeling is no longer just a hobby for me, it is a way of life. The most pleasant part of ship modeling is when the work is finished, the last flag and pennant are put in place. When you look at the model, you understand that the work is finished and you do not have to do anything more than sit back and admire your work. Ship modeling is not a sport for the weak-hearted. In fact, this is a hobby and lifestyle that does not go for weak by any stretch of the imagination. This is a hobby for which you change your life, for which you have disputes with your family, friends and loved ones. But this is what you live for. Ship modeling is a symbiosis of both sports and art. One of the oldest sports, namely the construction of ships, is when ship modeling appeared. Prototypes were made of the ships that were to be built. Ship modeling became the sport roughly in the 1920s. The first competitions took place in England, then in Germany, and then the first competition in the former Soviet Union was held in 1949. Ship modeling existed for a long time in Ukraine. An independent federation has existed since the collapse of the Soviet Union. It was officially registered in 1992. It is generally one of the leading ship modeling federations in the world and is highly respected. Since 2000 to this year, we have brought home around 400 medals from world championships. Every year we earn 25-29 medals at the world championships. Ship modeling in Ukraine among young people is developing as a technical sport and is gaining more and more popularity with every year. That is because it is interesting. Many young people get into history and find something for themselves, some in tanks, some in models. It was in 2010 that I accidentally came across the magazine Great Sailboats. I bought it just to take a look, thinking it would be really cool to assemble a model. Here I saw cool ships, looked at the model and thought I'd give it a try. I bought it, started assembling it and got hooked. Then I found out by accident about 2 or 3 years that it was actually a sport and the competitions were held. I then realized that I could go to those competitions, show my work and learn something new from the other participants. I was 12 years old, we came to the Palace of Pioneers on Arsenalna Street and saw radio-controlled cars there. That got me and my brother interested. We asked what it was and whether we could have a go at it. They told us it was a ship modeling club and that they were training on air-sea cars. We wanted those cars so bad that we signed up for ship modeling. Then we started working on boats and only saw those cars 3 or 4 years later. The impressions from the ship modeling club were the best ones I ever had during my times in school. There are about 50 or 60 model classes that are divided into 6 sections, according to their types and competition conditions. There are AB class models, there are AB group, or high-speed cord models. Ukraine is leading in this class. We have 2 merited masters of sports. We have set 17 world records. Radio-controlled sailing yacht models, replicants of C-class and M-class models. It is a very large group divided into 24 subclasses. They are divided by types of chassis, power of electric motors, battery capacities, and so on. The IHC class are radio-controlled replicas. A complete replica of the model is made according to blueprints and historical materials. Sometimes the search for historical authenticity takes many years. This year, a new class has been introduced, radio-controlled submarine models. You choose for yourself a ship by the parameters you like and want to make a replica. I participated in Class C, the replica models, and in the paper model class. Paper interested me by the fact that, first of all, it is the most difficult class. In my personal opinion, paper does not tolerate mistakes. It cannot be dyed or fixed with putty. That is forbidden by the rules. If you ruin a paper part, that's it. It's gone. Paper also attracts me by the fact that it is a good imitating material that replicates the surface of a real ship. I made my last model with the aim of winning first place at the World Cup. The goals were clearly defined, and a very complex ship with a huge amount of parts had been chosen. Replica, if we're talking about a championship models, takes anywhere from 1 to 3 years to complete to perfection. We work on several models at any given time. Some are quick to make, you participate in competitions with it and start working on another one. Replicas take several years to build. It is difficult to do monotonous things for long periods of time. This is why we work on several ships at the same time, but personally, I like speed models. You can take that away from me. But at the same time, speed has its own advantages. Those feelings cannot be described. If we compare a replica maker who spends all his time at a desk making beautiful models and a racer, those are completely different souls. Since making a replica is one thing, but when you are controlling a fast model, especially in a group race where everything depends not only on you, but on your rivals, also on the weather and other conditions, there are just so many interesting factors in this. Well, races are simply more of a thing for me. I didn't want to switch classes because, after all, expect replicas are made to stand modeling. Models can be artificially aged if you wish, to make them look like true ships that had traveled hundreds of miles across the seas. Controlled models have other properties and they must be able to move. And I am not interested in sacrificing something and losing beauty. It is dusty work, work with tools, and you need patience and perseverance when working with the needle and thread to sew the sails. That aside, for the most part, it is difficult work that requires a man's hands. The Federation began working closely with young people. We realized that the sport was getting old, so we started attracting young people. Initial training starts with training children starting from ages 7 or 8 years old. That is when their hand becomes more adept and they have more or less good control of the process. They begin with the simple models and then gradually move on to more complex models. When they have achieved a certain level of experience, they determine together with the coach which class the young pupil enjoys more. First, you need to have a huge desire to make a model, then you will have the patience for that. As for the technical skills, you have to know how to use a computer to find certain information on the internet. But also, you need straight hands, because you will still have to do the fine detailed work. I have my own approach to making models. I stray away from clichés and introduce some of my own technical and innovative ideas. Getting into paper models, the bottom of the ship is lined with stripes, which is not realistic, so I found information on how it is actually done and replicated it using paper. Then it is just like an actual ship. When you finish a model, you contemplate whether it is actually done, but usually there is always something to redo, alter, or improve. You can find some new information on a new button or a live buy. Well, earlier the research for information was limited to your city or country. Now people from various countries post a lot of information on forums that you didn't even know existed. Those could be documentary photos, for example, someone's grandfather served on a certain ship, and they happen to have preserved the photos with the part you need. Many foreign publishers publish certain literature, We find it on their websites, order it, and then the book arrives. We make everything according to the blueprints. My first model took 3.5 years to make. The biggest difficulty is the lack of a workshop. At first, I tried to find some forums to read up on what and where models were being made, and tried to find some circles of modeling fanatics, but that was rather difficult. I simply bought some instruments and tried to make something at home. I've been doing this for several years now, and I have a kind of workshop at home. So now I can let myself fantasize and bring my ideas to fruition in my paper models. Of course, there were many models. Starting with the first one, I can say that it was the most exciting adventure because it was the first one. It was a unique experience in making a radio-controlled model. Many different emotions accompanied the process of making it. I cried, I was happy, I was upset, but it mostly brought me great pleasure. After the first model, others followed. The experience of making the first model gives starts to work on the next ones. Every single one of them was interesting because all of them were different. There were speedboats, some were for naval battles, there were for the courses where you have to control your model through gates at high speeds. But with finishing every new model, every time you put it in water, it's like the first time, because all models move in different ways.
Такой же мандраж примерно, новые ощущения, потому что все модели едут по-разному.
I try not to miss the competitions held by the Federation of Ship Modeling. Starting from 2015, I took part in the Championship of Ukraine and the Kyiv Cup every year. It doesn't matter if my model is not finished, I bring it to some logical end and take it to the competitions. My first competition was the European Championship, where I got second place. I was upset because of my own mistakes, because I did not calculate certain things. But for the next year, I pulled myself together, worked everything out, made a new model, took part in the World Cup, and on my first attempt, I beat the world record by a couple of kilometers. Everyone was shocked. I myself was shocked. In my class, paper models, the pools and checks are competitive. There are also strong paperworks, as we call them. The competition is an occasion to meet up. Yes, we communicate in forums and the internet, but the actual competition, we can meet in real life.